Happy birthday, Frank. A celebration of what would have been Frank Sinatra's 100th birthday.
Me, ma, 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 moo, 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 me, mama. Happy birthday to me. Happy birthday to me. Happy birthday to myself. Happy birthday to me.
That's why the lady is a tramp. 'Cause you are the sunshine from my life. Chicago, 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 my time, hometown, Chicago.
Come on, fly with me, we'll fly. Swing forevermore.
And each time I do, just the thought of you makes me stop just before I begin.
'Cause it's witchcraft, wicked witchcraft. And although I know it's strictly taboo,
on December the 12th, Old Blue Eyes would have been 100. Joining me to celebrate the occasion is Sinatra aficionado, radio presenter, and also former president of the International Sinatra Society, Mr. Ken Wolfe. Welcome, Ken.
Indeed. Thank you very much indeed, Barry, for the invitation on this very auspicious occasion, celebrating the great man's 100th birthday.
Yes, very auspicious occasion indeed. Ken, you would have to have one of the largest, if not the largest, collection of Sinatra music in Australia.
Well, Barry, it goes right back to when I was 15 years of age. And believe it or not, that's 77 years ago.
Wow.
Or 75 years ago. And when I first heard Frank sing In the Blue of Evening, I've no idea why I became why I was so attracted to that voice, but ever since I've just loved his work. And yes, I have a large collection of Sinatra material and books, and still adding to it, much to the chagrin of my wife.
Yes, I can understand that. Unfortunately, as you know, only a few songs can fit into 45 minutes. So what say we start with Sinatra's Harry James period?
Well, why not? Frank was just 23 years of age when he made this. He made 10 recordings for Harry James, but the track we're going to play, I think, is All or Nothing at All, Barry.
That's it.
And that is, in my opinion, a classic.
All or nothing at all. Half a love never appealed to me. If your heart never could yield to me, then I'd rather have nothing at all. All or nothing at all. If it's love, there is no in between. Why begin and cry for something that might have been? No, I'd rather have nothing at all. Oh, please don't bring your lips so close to my cheek. Don't smile or I'll be lost beyond recall. The kiss in your eyes and the touch of your hand makes me weep, and my heart may grow dizzy and fall. And if I fell, under the spell of your call. I would be caught in the undertow, and so you see, I've got to say no, no.
Barry, that was just fantastic. I think I probably listened to that song hundreds of times, and it never gets stale. And Frank, of course, was just the boy vocalist at that stage with Harry James, but his phrasing, his diction, and the range of voice, he concludes that song, I believe, reaching the F octave. Unbelievable.
It is unbelievable, considering that was the first recording he did.
That's
right?
Exactly right.
With Harry James.
And it's interesting, Sinatra was always confident from the time he was 10 years of age that he was going to be a singer. That when it was first released, that only sold 8,000 copies.
Mm.
But later when he went out on his own in 1943 and there was a musician strike, they played that and sold over 1 million copies.
Incredible, isn't
Incredible.
It, back then. And talking of the 40s, as we all know, it was really his live performances that created, I guess, the Sinatra frenzy, which was spurred on by the Bobby Soxers. Of course, you'd remember that, Ken.
Yeah, I do. Well, of course, I was 15 years of age, a teenager, and I'd read about this skinny, scrawny young man with the wool bow ties, but when he got up to sing, the girls went mad, swoon. I thought, oh, God, I better listen to him, but he makes me swoon even now.
I think the girls would have outnumbered the boys listening to him back
yes,
in those days.
Yes, they'd sit there for four sessions. Incredible. I know the Beatles, perhaps Elvis Presley, but I don't think there's ever been such adulation as Frank Sinatra in the 40s.
You'd be right there. Talking of the 40s... on the subject of concerts, Frank's first concert tour of Australia was in 1955, and I believe you were there.
I was certainly there. It was in January 1955, and at that stage it was like the Messiah was coming to Australia. yes, we went there. I saw both concerts, and I couldn't get over it. Just fantastic. Magnificent.
How about that? It would have been. Well, you were at the start of the whole thing, really, weren't you?
That's right.
Back to Harry James. Frank was only with Harry for a few months, correct?
6 months, that's all.
Yeah,
and
not long.
He was on a salary of $75. And Tommy Dorsey, of course, the big band era was dominated mainly by Glenn Miller and Tommy Dorsey.
Yeah, correct.
And when Sinatra was offered a job with Tommy Dorsey at $125 a week,
wow.
Harry James, his friend, kindly let him out of his contract. That was the start of a new era for Sinatra.
That's quite a bit of money going back that
Oh, yes, indeed.
Era. Okay, what have we got next for us, Ken?
Well, I think we're going to play something from the Dorsey era, aren't we?
Correct.
And this is a wonderful sound of early Frank Sinatra, 24 years of age, with the Tommy Dorsey Orchestra.
East of the Sun.
Correct. Thank you.
east of the sun.
Big Ben, the bright man.
And west of the moon.
I'll be digging the globe.
We'll build a dream house.
A righteous path.
Of love.
Where you can really lay it on me.
Near to the sun in the day.
We'll be jumping.
And near to the moon at night.
You'll be with me.
We'll live in a lovely way, dear.
Solitude, I'm here.
Living on love and pale moonlight.
And hello.
Just you and I.
We'll mix the squares.
Forever and a day.
So long, so long.
Love will not die.
We're together forever.
We'll keep it that way.
Forever.
Up among the stars we'll find a harmony of life to a lovely tune. East of the sun and west of the moon.
On a June night, kiss me and hold tight forever.
East of the sun and west of the moon.
Well, all right then, take 'em.
East of the sun.
Made men. Right now.
And west of the moon.
We'll be digging the globe.
We'll build a dream house.
A righteous path.
Of love.
Where you can really lay it on me.
Near to the sun in the day.
We'll be jumping.
And near to the moon at night.
You'll be with
we'll
me.
We'll live in a lovely way,
dear. Solitude, I'm here.
Living on love and pale moonlight.
Hello.
Just you and I.
We'll mix the squares.
Forever and a day.
So long, so long.
Love will not die.
We're together forever.
We'll keep it that way.
Forever.
Up among the stars we'll find a harmony of life to a lovely tune. East of the sun and west of the moon.
On a June night, kiss me and hold tight forever.
East of the sun and west of the moon.
Well, all right then, take 'em. Bunny!
Frank Sinatra from a live performance, Barry, and he was only 24 years of age. Outstanding with such a huge orchestra.
Amazing.
And of course, Tommy Dorsey featured a lot of instrumentalist stars, Buddy Rich on the drums.
Correct.
Joe Bushkin on the piano, Ziggy Elman, and Bunny Berrigan on trumpets. Now, as Sinatra grew, and the next song he recorded was I'll Never Smile Again, which was one of the greatest hits of 1940. Dorsey came to appreciate that although he had these great instrumentalists, the kids who were dancing, when Frank came to the band, they would forget about them and just listen to Sinatra. And so he realised, Dorsey, that instead of just being the boys' singer, in 1941 he was... He defeated Bing Crosby as the singer of the year.
Mm-hmm.
And so Dorsey gave him a leading role. And we're going to listen to Everything Happens to Me, a beautiful song.
Absolutely. Beautiful.
Written by, I've just forgotten the names of now, but great songwriters. Just listen to this. Everything Happens to Me.
Cats creep across my path until I'm almost mad. I must have roused the devil's wrath, 'cause all my luck is bad. I make a date for golf
and you can bet your life it rains. I try to give a party, but the guy upstairs complains. I guess I'll go through life just catching colds and missing trains. Everything happens to me. I never miss a thing. I've had the measles and the mumps, and every time I play an ace, my partner always trumps. I guess I'm just a fool who never looks before he jumps. Everything happens to me. At first my heart thought you could break this jinx for me, that love would turn the trick to end despair. But now I just can't fool this head that thinks for me. So I've mortgaged all my castles in the air. I've telegraphed and phoned, sent an airmail special too. Your answer was goodbye. There was even postage due. I fell in love just once, and then it had to be with you. Everything happens to me. I've never drawn a sweepstake or a bank night at a show. I thought perhaps this time I'd won, but Lady Luck said no. And though it breaks my heart, I'm not surprised to see you go. Everything happens to me. Everything happens to me.
Don't know why there's no sun up in the sky. Stormy weather since my gal and I ain't together. Keeps raining all the time. Life is bare, gloom and misery everywhere. Stormy weather just can't get my poor old self together. I'm weary all the time, the time. So weary all the time. When she went away, the blues walked in and they met me. If she stays away, that old rocking chair's gonna get me. All I do is pray the Lord above will let me walk in. Can't go on. Everything I had is gone. Stormy weather since my gal and I ain't together. Keeps raining all the time. Keeps raining all. Thank you.
in and met me.
If he stays away, old rocking chair will get me.
All I do is pray the Lord among will let me walk in the sun once more. Since my gal and I ain't together, keeps raining all the time, the time. Keeps raining all the
Magnificent stuff, Barry. And Frank there was accompanied by the great Axel Stordahl and his orchestra. Violins, cellos, the works, strings. That song was written by Harold Arlen 70 years ago and 80 years ago, and is still alive, still fresh today as the day it was written.
80 years, that's unbelievable.
It is indeed.
Incredible.
And Sinatra, of course, recorded that in 1943 when he went out, 1945, when he went out on his own. And he was worried about how he would perform, but he was the most popular singer in America. It's interesting, Barry, that Frank Sinatra sang during nine decades. From 1939 to 1993, nine decades.
There's very few.
Incredible people.
There'd be very few can make that claim.
But let's get back to Everything Happens to Me, one of my very favourite Sinatra tunes, which he recorded on four occasions. That song was recorded 75 years ago. And later on in the program, we're going to play another version of Everything Happens to Me, in 40 years later, when he was 64. I think we'll enjoy it. But again, the phrasing, the diction, it's just magnificent. I get carried away with Frank Sinatra, even at my age.
I do a little bit too, but we won't go into that. What label did he go to when he left Tommy Dorsey?
He made 83 official recordings with the Tommy Dorsey Orchestra. And he was only with Tommy for 2 years and 2 months, 10 months. And then he was offered a contract by Columbia Recordings. And he's made his first feature film called Higher and Higher, which Frank always considered calling it Lower and Lower. But he sang some beautiful songs in that, and he was off on his career.
Well, here's another favourite of yours, Ken, Birth of the Blues.
These are the blues. Nothing but blues. Oh, they say some people long ago were searching for a different tune, one that they could croon as only they can. They only had the rhythm, so they started swaying to and fro. They didn't know just what to use. This is how the blues really began. They heard the breeze in the trees singing weird melodies, and they made that the start of the blues. and from a jail came the wail of a downhearted frail, and they played that as a part of the blues. From a whippoorwill way up on a hill, they took a new note, pushed it through a horn until it was worn into a blue note. And then they nursed it, they rehearsed it, and then sent out that news that the Southland gave birth to the blues. They nursed it, then they rehearsed it, and they sent out that news that the Southland, they gave birth to the happened in Monterey a long time ago. I met her in Monterey in old Mexico. Stars and steel guitars and luscious lips as red as wine broke somebody's heart, and I'm afraid that it was mine. It happened in Monterey without thinking twice. I left her and threw away the key to paradise. My indiscreet heart longs for the sweetheart that I left in old Monterey. It happened in Monterey a long time ago. I met her in Monterey in old Mexico. Stars, guitar, lips red as wine broke somebody's heart, and I fear that it was mine. It happened in Monterey, and without thinking twice, I left her and I threw away the key to paradise. My indiscreet heart, how it longs for that sweetheart that I left in old Monterey.
Great choice, Ken. Classic Sinatra.
Absolutely. And we'll go back to the first track we played, The Birth of the Blues, Barry. A wonderful song, of course, first made famous by the great Louis Armstrong. But in 1952, Sinatra was really down and out. The Bobby Sox had grown up, and Sinatra's contract finished with Birth of the Blues. They thought he was finished, his voice was gone, and he was down and out. But being Sinatra, of course, he wasn't going to give up. He fought very, very hard to get the role of Margio in that classic film From Here to Eternity. He was so good that he was awarded the Academy Award for the Best Supporting Actor of 1954. As well as that, he was given a contract with Capitol Recordings, and he collaborated with perhaps one of, if not the greatest, orchestra and arranger of all time, Nelson Riddle. And from there on, his career just went further and further north.
Drinking again and thinking of when you loved me. I'm having a few and wishing that you were here. Making the rounds, accepting a round from strangers. Being a fool, just hoping that you'll appear. Sure, I can borrow a smoke, maybe tell some joker that joke. But nobody laughs, they don't laugh at a broken heart. Same old story. After the kicks, there's little old mixed up me. Trying to lose dream that used to be. Look at me, I'm drinking again, drinking all over town. Yeah, I'm drinking again. Thanks for the memory of things I can't forget. Journeys on a jet, our wondrous week in Martinique and Vegas and roulette. How lucky I was. And thanks for the memory of summers by the sea, dawn in Waikiki. We had a pad in London, but we didn't stop for tea. How cozy it was. Now since our breakup, I wake up
alone on a gray morning after. I long for the sound of your laughter, and then I see the laughs on me. But thanks for the memory of every touch, a thrill. I've been through the mill. I've lived a lot and learned a lot. You love me not, and still I miss you so much. Thanks for the memory of how we used to jog, even in a fog, that barbecue in Malibu, away from all the smog. How rainy it was. Thanks for the memory of letters I destroyed, books that we enjoyed. Tonight, the way things look, I need a book by Sigmund Freud. How brainy he was. Gone are those evenings on Broadway. Together we'd go to a great show. But now I begin with a late show and wish that you were watching too. I know it's a fallacy that grown men never cry. Baby, that's a lie. We had a bed of roses, but forgot that roses die. And thank you so much.
Two great tracks, Barry. Drinking Again. Sinatra was always considered the greatest saloon song of all time. That's certainly a splendid example. And then he did Thanks for the Memory, a tune which was always associated with the Bob Hope, written in 1938. But that's a new set of lyrics. One of the last tracks that Sinatra did, and he still had a great voice, Barry. We're going to conclude, Barry, with we played earlier in the program Everything Happens to Me, 1941. Sinatra recorded it 40 years later at the age of 64 with new lyrics. I think you'll enjoy it. Everything Happens to Me.
I've stamped my daydreams canceled, and the winter's getting cold. Everything happens to me. I I've known a lot of ladies, but there's something that I lack. Each time that there's a breakup, I'm the one who holds the sack. And when I give my heart away, I always get it back. Everything happens to me. At first my heart thought you could break this jinx for me, that love would turn the trick to end despair. But now I just can't fool this head that thinks for me. And I've mortgaged all my castles in the air. Now in the school of life, well, I was lucky just to pass. Now I'm chasing rainbows with the losers in the class. But pal, you don't find rainbows in the bottom of a glass. Everything happens to me.
Oh, indeed, Barry. We played the 1941 version when Frank had a voice, a light tenor, but 40 years later he had that deep baritone, and whatever you think, he is the greatest. Overused word, the only one I can... John Bradman had a batting average of 99.94, no one's as good as Bradman, and there's no one as good as Sinatra or ever will be.
You're right. Thank you so much, Ken, for joining us on this special occasion.
It was delighted to be here, Barry, and thank you for the invitation.
This has been Happy Birthday, Frank, a Sounds of Sinatra special presentation.